Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here end the exposition of Mark 14:47 onward. And one of them that stood by drew a sword, that was Peter, and smote a servant of the high priest, and cut off his ear. And Christ Jesus answered and said unto them, Are ye come out as against a thief, with swords and with staves, to take me? I was daily with you in the temple preaching, and not teaching, you know. Teaching is moral law, preaching is gospel. And ye took me not, but the scriptures must be fulfilled. And they all forsook him and fled. And there followed him a certain young man, having a linen cloth cast about his naked body. And the young man laid hold on him, and he left the linen cloth and fled from them naked. Now this I can't understand. And what is that? The spiritual understanding is, the young man with the linen around it, and they took the cloth off, make it naked, you know, like little children maybe, because in Christ Jesus we have to be like little children who take off our clothes and trample over them. That means what is inside, we are outside. And they led Christ Jesus away to the high priest, and with him were assembled all the chief priests and the elders and the scribes. And Peter followed him afar off. So Peter followed Christ Jesus because he loved him, and he has promised that he won't forsake him, even into the palace of the high priest. So he even went to the palace of the high priest, and he sat with the servants. There were servants of the high priest, as Pope has servants, and all those with these soldiers standing with spears and whatnot, guarding Antichrist, and warmed himself at the fire. And the chief priests and all the council sought for witness against Christ Jesus to put him to death. So they just wanted witness, because they were men of letters. According to the letters, you must have two witnesses before you accuse a person. So there you are. They were trying to find two witnesses to accuse Christ Jesus, and found none. So nobody dared to speak, give a false testimony. For many bear false witness against him, but the witness agreed not together. So they were not agreeing together. They were not of one accord. And there arose certain and bear false witness against him, saying, We heard him say, I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and within 3 days I will build another made without hands is the physical body. But neither so did their witness agree together. So even that did not agree with together. So, and the high priest stood up in the midst and asked Jesus, saying, Answers thou nothing? You are not defending yourself. What is it which these witness against thee? So the high priest acted psychologically, and he roared, as sometimes you see these false Christ people, televangelists and other things, how they roar Christ Jesus had died for sinners and all that pack of lies they tell. And so is, you know, this their high priest then roared in among them, spoke very high at high tone. But he held his peace and answered nothing. But Christ Jesus held his peace, he didn't answer them. Because they won't hear what he say, they know him in their heart what he is. Again the high priest asked him and said unto him, art thou the Christ, the Son of the Blessed? No, look, they knew that he the Son of the High, Son of the God, or Son of the Blessed, who has come to take the fruit of the wine press, the Jerusalem temple. So they, in that parable, they knew that it is he who has come. And Christ Jesus said, I am. Now when he was, this was second time. First was in the once born stage, and second one he was saying in a sensible question he was asking. And Jesus gave a sensible answer, and Jesus said, I am. And ye shall see the Son of Man sitting on the right hand of power and coming in the clouds of heaven. So there Jesus then told him, you know, what the power of the sons of God is, because he was twice born now, but of evil spirit. Then the high priest rent his clothes, because Antichrist people, they wanted to instigate, or they wanted to bring some roars, or some psychic technology or psychic thing to excite the people, to incite them, you know, against Christ Jesus. So he tore his clothes in anger, showing that he is very angry at this man. So that the crowd or the people who are there, once born fanatic, the swine, they also can show their anger. What need we any further witness? He said, why what we need any further witness? Because they knew he is the Son of God who has come to take the fruit of the wine press. Ye have heard the blasphemy. What think ye? And they all condemned him to be guilty of death. So all those people who are standing there, as he has acted psychologically, so all they shouted for in favor of the high priest. And some began to spit on him and to cover his face and to buffet him and to say unto him, prophesy. And the servants did strike him with the palms of their hands. So the general public and those stooges who were of the high priest, the swines, they start to hit Christ Jesus and disgrace him. And as Peter was beneath in the palace, there cometh one of the maids of the high priest. Now you remember, Peter is once born, his habits are like child. Now if you beat the child, given corporal punishment, that he gets frightened. And sometimes corporal punishment is the only punishment that a child understands. So when they were beating Christ Jesus, he was very much frightened, Peter, that look, my master is being beaten, and who the hell I am to defend myself. So he got frightened of the scene. There cometh one of the maids of the high priest, and when she saw Peter warming himself, she looked upon him and said, and thou, I know not, neither understand I what thou sayest. And I will explain this one in the next video. Thank you very much.